করতে গেলেই তো তো
মাইক সরছে তো কারণ মাইক সরছে তো রেড লাইট লাগলো
পান বন্ধ কষাল করাছ মন তুমি
চারি রেড লাইট লাগলো তো
আমি
টেনশন করে
डायग्राम काढायचे तुम्हाला अर्धा मिनिटात कट पण पाहिजे
दोन मिनिटं लवकर सोडा
ना आता टिक टिक करून टिक टिक करून
दहा पर्यंत आहे ना
11:10 गुड मॉर्निंग मायसेल्फ सुमित करंजेकर फ्रॉम जे जे आर आई टी नागपूर सो टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू टीच ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ मशीनिंग प्रोसेसेस अँड दी टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज बेसिकली द लेथ मशीन अँड इट्स फंक्शनल पार्ट सो तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ड्रॉ द डायग्राम ऑफ द लेथ मशीन अँड देन वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरंट principal parts and their functions of the lathe machine. So let us draw the block diagram for the lathe machine. So this is basically the bed portion of the lathe machine. So we will name it afterwards. So first this is the basically the lathe bed we drawn. So at the bottom of this lathe bed, that is, this is the foundation legs. These are the foundation legs on which all these lathe parts are situated or mounted. So this is basically the foundation leg, so on which all the weight of the lathe machine are mounted. Okay, and this basically these foundation legs are grounded to the ground, or simple bolted to this ground. Okay, the next element of this lathe machine is basically the headstock. So this is the headstock, just name it headstock. So at the front of the headstock there is a spindle, and at the extension of the spindle it consists of the chuck is nothing but the rotating member of this lathe machine. So it may be of different types of chuck, 3-jaw chuck, 4-jaw chuck, or any different workpiece holding devices. So this is our chuck for holding the workpiece, and this is our headstock. So headstock basically carries all the gearing mechanism inside it. Basically it consists of the back gear mechanism, which ultimately provide the control efficient speed or motion to the workpiece, or it also used for the threading operation or efficient threading operation. So the next element for this lathe machine, that is our tailstock. So the headstock is basically found toward the left side of this lathe machine, and the tailstock situated toward the right portion of our lathe machine. So simply we can draw here the tailstock. So tailstock consists of the center that is called as the dead center. Okay, so we can write it as the dead center of this particularly tailstock. It consists of the hand wheel here. So by moving this hand wheel, you can move this dead center towards and inside with respect to this lathe center. Okay, this is the center line of the lathe machine. So the center of your chuck and the center of your tailstock should be matched. So, and another, this is the clamping wall, you can say. You can clamp this particular tailstock at any portion between this lathe at any place. So this particularly tailstock, we can write it as a tail stock. So this tailstock is basically mount over the lathe bed guide ways. It is mounted over the lathe bed guide ways. So these are the lathe bed guide ways. Okay, so simply we can write it as a lathe bed guide ways. So we have to mount this particular tailstock over this lathe bed guide wheel. So you can slide this tailstock to the entire area over this particular lathe bed guide wheel. So the another element in this particularly lathe machine is our carriage. So simply carriage is basically mounted between the headstock and the tailstock. So this is our carriage. Simply this carriage is mounted between the headstock and tailstock. Okay, so the upper portion of this carriage is called as the saddle. So this much is saddle. The whole assembly of the carriage together called as, basically it is the carriage, but it is separated into the different parts. Means the front portion of this lathe machine. So this is the front portion of the lathe machine. It has the separate name, that is the apron. So this is basically the carriage, but the separate name given to the front panel of this carriage, that is our apron. So this is the apron. So apron basically carries the whole controlling lever over this area, the front panel. So the first element with this apron is the carriage lever. कैरेज लीवर और कैरेज हैंडविल, कैरेज हैंडविल। सो सिंपली बाय दिस कैरेज हैंडविल यू कैन मूव होल दिस कैरेज ओवर दिस लेट ब्रेड गाइड वे बिटवीन योर द हेड स्टॉक एंड द टेल स्टॉक। सो दिस इज योर हैंडविल, हैंडविल फॉर carriage movement, or simply you can say motion. So there is another lever also available with this apron, that is your cross slide lever. So this is the cross slide lever. So simply we can name it as the cross slide lever. So basically the cross slide is mounted over this carriage at this place. So this is your the cross slide, means this much portion which is available at the upper portion of the carriage, you can move cross to the sled bed using your cross slide lever or cross slide handwheel. Simply you can move this, and this particular the slide or cross slide move in this direction cross to the sled bed. So you can perform the operation of facing using or by moving this cross side handwheel. So the another portion or another element or the part available at the upper portion of this particular the cross slide, that is your compound rest. So compound rest is available at the upper portion of your cross slide. So this is your compound rest, this is your compound rest. This compound rest simply available at the top of your cross slide. It consists of the another handwheel means, and the basically the function of your compound rest means this portion is to take the angular cut or your metal workpiece. Simply this carriage is helps particularly for operation of your simply you can say the turning operation. Okay, turning operation is used with or you can perform with your handwheel or your carriage by the movement of this handwheel for the carriage. Simply you can move this, it will move in longitudinal direction along the lathe bed, and you can perform the turning operation. And another, that is the cross slide, you can perform the facing operation by moving this particular cross slide against the workpiece perpendicularly. So that will be your facing operation. But these two operations basically you can say the perpendicular operation. One is moving along the lathe bed, and another operation is the cross to the lathe bed. But if you want any angular cutting operation, so at this time you have to use basically the compound rest. How? So simply this compound rest you can swivel at any angle as per the requirement. So this is the arrangement for the movement of this compound rest at any direction, so that you can take the any angular cut using this compound rest. So this is our compound rest. This is our compound rest. Compound. So at the top of the compound rest, it consists of your tool post. So this is the tool post available at the top of your compound rest, and the basic function of this tool post, tool post, is to hold the single point cutting tool. So single point cutting tool is available at this portion for taking any or simply machining of any metal work. So this is the hand wheel or simply lever for engaging or holding this particularly single point cutting tool. Single point cutting tool. So these are the some functional part of the lathe. Another part is basically the chip tray. So the chip tray is basically available at this portion. So this is your chip tray. Simply name it as the chip tray. What is the function of chip tray? So simply whatever the cutting material or machining material available during your cutting operation, that available or fall inside or in this particular chip tray. So you can simply remove this chip material or metal parts from this chip tray. Also there is a portion or simply port for the coolant. Means simply while taking or performing the operation, so the coolant is available at the machining area, and during the machining the coolant is continuously fall inside this tray, and there is a availability of pipe, and simply you can, with this pipe you can drain out the coolant or used coolant from the this chip tray. So these are some principal parts. So different operation you can perform with this lathe machine. Basically the first operation we can say that is the facing operation. The first operation that is called as facing operation. So machining operation, simply machining operation, operation by lathe. The first is your facing operation. Facing operation. What is facing operation? Facing operation is, in case of the facing operation, your cross light will help. So this is the cross light already discussed. By the movement of this cross light hand wheel, you can move this cross light perpendicularly to the bed. If there is the workpiece available at the chuck, this is your chuck. Chuck, it may be 3-jaw chuck or 4-jaw chuck. So this is our workpiece available at your chuck, that is the workpiece holding device. While performing your facing operation, your cutting tool is always moves क्रॉस टू द लेथ बेड, क्रॉस टू द लेथ बेड. सो दिस इज योर टूल. And while performing the facing operation, this tool will move in perpendicular direction to the lathe or perpendicular direction to this lathe axis. So this is lathe axis. So during the facing operation, the tool will move from this portion to the this portion, moving perpendicular. The next operation, that is the turning. Second operation is turning. Turning operation. So in case of turning operation, we have to use hold this carriage for taking the turning operation or turning cut. So simply, for your turning operation, the workpiece is to be placed with your work holding device, that is a chuck. It may be 3-jaw or 4-jaw. So this is your the workpiece here, and the tool available at this portion, single point cutting tool. So as in case of the facing operation, tool moving perpendicular to the lathe axis, but in case of your turning operation, by the movement of your carriage along your guide lathe bed guideways, it will move parallel to this lathe axis. It will move to parallel to the lathe axis. This is our lathe axis. This is your single point cutting tool. This is your hand wheel for the carriage. By this motion, whole carriage along with the single point cutting tool, it will move in along the direction of this parallel to the lathe axis. So this is our single point cutting tool available here, and you can perform the turning operation by moving the single point cutting tool parallel to the lathe axis. So it will be your turning operation. So while in case of first the facing operation, what you actually do in the facing operation? In case of the facing operation, you always reduce the length of the work. Always reduce the length of the workpiece. Simply, during the facing operation, this much portion will be removed. This after next cut, this will portion will be removed. This one portion will be removed. So what actually happened here? Simply, the length of this workpiece, it will get reduced. And what is actually happened in the turning operation? Turning operation, you can see here, while taking the turning operation, the diameter of this workpiece, it will reduce. Diameter of the workpiece is reduced. Simply by first cut, you can remove the this much portion. Next cut, you will remove this much portion. So at this time, the diameter of your workpiece, it will get reduced. It will get reduced while during your turning operation. So during turning operation, your carriage plays the role. Your facing operation, your cross light plays the role. And the nape operation, that is the taper turning. So the third operation is taper turning. Taper turning. So during the taper turning operation, you have to use the separate part or principal part of your lathe machine, that is your compound rest. Your compound rest will play the role while performing the taper operation. Taper operation is nothing but the angular operation while cutting the angular shape. Simply, you can say, so here in case of the facing operation and your turning operation, the operation is carried in orthogonal way. Orthogonal way means simply perpendicular to the lathe axis, and this is the parallel to the lathe axis. But in this portion, we can, or in this function, or during in turning operation or facing operation, you can't take the angular cut. So while cutting the angular cut, that is called as taper turning operation, you have to use your compound rest. As I already told that this compound rest you can swivel at any required angle over this particular cloth line. There is the scale available at the compound rest at the bottom portion. You can maintain particular angle as per the requirement, and simply you can take the angular cut by moving this hand wheel. So this is the hand wheel for the compound rest for while taking the angular cut. So this is the hand wheel, basically hand wheel. So simply third is your taper turning operation. What will happen? So you have the workpiece, you have to cut in angular way like this. So you can see here, these are the orthogonal workpieces, but this is the angular workpiece. So the tool will be available here, and in this case of taper turning, your compound rest will help. And in this case, this tool will move in angular direction, is like this, which is not perpendicular or not parallel to the lathe axis. So simply you have to swivel this particularly compound rest at required angle, and you will perform a taper turning operation. The next operation for this lathe machine is drilling operation. So there are n number of operations available with your lathe machine. So next is the drilling operation. So how will you perform the drilling operation in the lathe machine? So while performing the drilling operation, you must have the drilling tool. So the drilling tool you can use with this lathe machine. But at what place? You can't use the drilling tool in the portion of along with your tool post. So there is a separate place for holding the drill tool, that is nothing but your tailstock. So simply the drill bit you have to place here in place of the dead center. Simply you can remove this dead center, and at place of the dead center